Good morning, everybody. About to go head out and get a lower body workout session in. And then we are gonna go to the Strawberry Festival here in Tampa, Florida. They have it every year and there's literally strawberry everything. And yeah, I'm gonna go get a classic strawberry shortcake. And it's like build your own. So you can kind of put as much on there as you want. And yeah, it warmed up this morning when I woke up. It was 39 degrees outside and now it's already 54 degrees. So that's just Florida for you. It warms up pretty quickly. And yeah, let's go do it. Cheers. But it's 30 grams of protein down the hatchet. Let's go. All right, so on the workout program today is lower body. We have sumo squats, sissy squats, and then we have some single leg things like single leg press, single leg calf raises, some hip adduction. And yeah, this is my last exercise program. No, today is the, this is the last exercise day I have on this block of training. So I'm really gonna push myself to see how heavy I can go because I'm wrapping it up with this block and then I'm moving on to something new. I'm sumo deadlifting 205 right now, and I would love for my finishing weight to be 225, four sets of six reps, so we'll see if I can get that. It's gonna be a really heavy, that's two red plates on each side, let's see. That is a PR right there. 225, four sets of six reps. Yes. See what I eat before I train. This morning I happened to have just a protein shake and a bowl of Cinnamon Toast Crunch, which is about 40 to 50 grams of carbohydrates, fast acting carbohydrates. It helped me hit a PR today. So if you want to try a bowl of cereal before you lift, try it out, see if it gives you some energy. Normally there is no set number of carbohydrates that you should or should not have before a gym session. It's mostly preference. A lot of people don't like to work out with a really full stomach, but some people need a little bit more feeling satiated and full before they hit some big lifts. So yeah, whatever you decide, do what works for you and keep it consistent. This has been working for me since I've been able to have more fuel for my lifts. Really awesome feeling getting stronger in the gym and hitting some performance goals, and yeah, throwing in a couple PRs in there, I'm a happy girl. doing calf raises on the leg press machine, especially single leg, really allows you to get a full stretch at the bottom of your calf raises, and it's very controllable. I know a lot of times when I do the standing calf raise machine, it's a little bit too tall and I can't adjust it to go lower, so I can't really sink into my heels as far and get a deep stretch in my calf. Yeah, try out these single leg calf raises on the leg press machine, and let me know how you like that. That was a phenomenal workout. I'm so excited that I PR'd in my sumo squats today. And yeah, so this may be TMI, but I'm actually on my monthly right now, and I didn't think I was gonna have a great workout just because it's the follicular phase and usually you're a little bit more fatigued and you don't have as much of your strength as you normally do. I actually PR'd on it, so that's exciting. But it's a beautiful day outside and looking forward to eating my face out of some strawberry shortcake. And yeah, I think I earned it today. Let's see how it goes. Made it to the Plant City Strawberry Festival, which I remember when I was young. All the cool kids rode the Ring of Fire, all the older kids. And if you went on it, you were brave. And so that was kind of like my first upside down little roller coaster ride that I've been on. It smells so good. It's like a mixture of like a smoky campfire with like fried funnel cakes and all the goodies.
Well, since we've been done, I've been trying to unfall apart. And I've been thinking that some neon lights would be a real good start. Well, I called a couple friends, but they all say they're staying in, so I guess I'm going out on my own. I might be heartbroken, but that don't mean I gotta stay home. I can buy my own drinks, and I can pay my own tab. And at the end of the night, when they cut on all the lights, I can call my own. a dive, the type that he would never walk in. And then a guy at the bar sees an empty drink in my hand. Yeah, I said, it's sweet of you to ask if you can fill my glass, but I'm gonna have to pass this time. Well, me and myself, well, yeah, we're doing just fine. I can buy my own drinks, and I can pay my own tab. And at the end of the night, when they cut on all the lights, I can call my own cab. I can drop my own change in the jukebox. I can dance all by myself till I can stop thinking about drinking about him. I don't need nobody else. Yeah, I can buy my own drinks
tonight, tonight, tonight.
Yeah, I can buy my own drinks
tonight, tonight, tonight.
I can walk my own self to the front door. I can take my own self to bed. I can medicate my own headache. Yeah, I can be my own boyfriend. And I can buy my own drinks. I can pay my own tab. And at the end of the day.
Difficulty, pointed toes, and if he stays on the trail. Look at those 12 o'clock kickouts. Pointed toes, finishing it off with a huge one and a half double twisty.
In lane number three, it's Kim Kardashian. And in lane number four, we have Taylor Not So Swift.
Alright guys, so that is a wrap for today and our adventures at the Strawberry Festival. If you haven't already, please share, like, and definitely subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.